We are under the lights as the show gets you ready for another edition of Major League Baseball. Tonight, an intriguing matchup between the New York Yankees and the Minnesota Twins. It's time for Twins Baseball next. Kenta Maeda is on the mound for game two. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Hey, this guy pitched really well in his last outing, only allowing one run. If he brings that kind of stuff to the ballpark, he has a chance to pitch another gem in this one.
Here's Brett Gardner now. He enters play sixth leading in the American League in the batting race.
This isn't this guy's first rodeo. He's been in the league for quite a while now. This wily veteran is having a great year.
Here it comes. Underway in the second of four here this weekend as the game's first pitch is taken for ball one. And guys, as we take a look at the Twins at the start of play here tonight, they come into this one off a loss that finally snapped what was a long, long winning streak.
Yeah, Matty, taking a look at the standings right here. This team has a nice lead, comfortable. You always want to find yourself in a position where you're about 5 to 9 games, got the advantage. You don't. One series isn't going to totally kill you in the standings, and this team's sitting pretty right now.
3-0 now.
I don't blame him for not coming over the heart of the plate. He circled this guy on the lineup card when he got to the yard today. He's been swinging one of the hotter bats in the game.
Three and one now to Brett Gardner.
Down to 3-1.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Fouled away. Three-two pitch. And he lays off. Ball four. And the leadoff man is on to begin the ball game.
Batting second, the second baseman, DJ.
Stepping up to the plate, DJ LeMahieu. And as you check out his righty-lefty splits, no surprise that he hits better against southpaws than he does against right-handers. Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. LeMahieu is undoubtedly one of the best hitters in the sport, and it doesn't matter, right-handed or left-handed pitching, he's one of the elite threats with a bat in his hands. That evens it up, 1-1. Gardner on at first, nobody out. And there's ball two now. Previous head-to-head matchups with Kenta Maeda, he's got 5 base hits in 24 at-bats. He's taken him deep once. Line to the right side. In there, a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Boy, so frustrating as a pitcher. You make a quality pitch on the inside half of the plate right there. Try to bust him in, D-Row, and he fights it off the other way.
Yeah, you tip your hat to the pitcher right there. He executed his pitch, but nice job by the offensive player fighting. It doesn't matter what it looks like. A knock's a knock.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. Lays off 1-0. Well, time to look at our umpires in this one. Behind the plate is Dave Lawrence.
Damn, we got Dave Lawrence behind the dish tonight. One of the best in the business, in my opinion, but sometimes has a tendency to fall into a pattern where he's given a little bit too much on that outside corner.
Yeah, D-World, one of the things he'll do, he'll open up that outside corner, especially with left-handed batters.
Now the 1-1 pitch. Line toward right center, and that's in there. Base hit. Gardner rounds third and is digging for the plate. The run comes across to score, and they jump ahead 1-0.
Boy, after scoring a boatload yesterday, D-Will, they're off to a fast start again, striking here in the first inning.
Yeah, this offense is on fire. Obviously, the hitting meeting resonated with these guys. Scored a ton yesterday and picked up right where they left off.
So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Giancarlo Stanton. And as you take a look at the splits here, he's actually better against right-handed pitching this season. First pitch on its way.
Ball one.
A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0.
This is exactly the situation you drew up from an offensive standpoint. Good pitcher on the mound, but you got a chance to bury him early in this one.
The 1-0 is looked at off the plate for a ball. Down low, and the plot thickens here, 3-0.
This is a spot you like to be in as a good hitter. Runners in scoring position and count leverage in your favor.
The 3-0. Runners at the corners here, nobody out. 3 balls and 2 strikes to the Yankees DH. With 2 strikes now and a runner at first, do you go for the strikeout or are you still looking for the double play ball?
Good time to try to put the ball down in the strike zone. You could either get a strikeout or a potential double play ball.
Now the 3-2 pitch. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out.
That is it.
Digging in now for the Yankees, Torres. And the Yanks trying to make this first inning even sweeter here. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. So far this season, with runners in scoring position, Torres is holding on to a batting average way down in the 210s.
He'd be the first to tell you he's not happy with his batting average this season, but he can beat.
And this one gets away. What a bad time for a wild pitch as the run will score from third.
Yeah, and when you're losing, there's usually a good reason for it. They're already down, and then he lets this one get away from him. They better keep them within striking distance, or this thing is going to get lopsided in a hurry.
Two-oh count, the pitch. Hey. 23 pitches already here in the first inning. Started to chase that time, but then he wisely holds off for ball three.
We got a full
and it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
When you get yourself to a 3-1 count and you get a fastball, those are the ones you really want to punish. Couldn't get the bat on it, so we'll see if that comes back to haunt him.
Now the payoff pitch home. Hit on the ground out to short. Gonzalez is up with it. Throw gets him. 2 down.
Batting fifth, the catcher, Gary Sanchez.
Now batting, Gary Sanchez. And he's looking to snap out of what's been a rather dry spell at the plate. First pitch of the at-bat on its way.
1-0.
I think this inning could have far-reaching effects in this game. They're really making him work, and unless he dials it in, it's probably going to limit how deep he goes into this game.
Runs outside, so it goes to 2-0 now.
If you've been paying attention, the guy on the mound does not want to come inside. If I'm at the plate, I'm leaning out over.
3-0 now. has a look. Now the pitch.
Even though it's early on in this one, anytime you get runners in scoring position, you'd like to knock them in.
The 3-1 pitch. And that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with two out.
At this rate, he's going to set some kind of a record for walks issued in a game, or he'll get an early hook. We'll see if he can settle down here and start to find the strike zone, or if he continues to struggle.
Here's Miguel Andujar now, and he comes into this one having hit safely in his last five games. Looking to minimize the damage here. Swing and a line drive. But he just missed his extra bases. Chop foul at the plate here, and it's 0-2. Two down, runners at first and second. That misses, 1-2. And 2-2.
This is a huge pitch right here. I don't think he wants to go 3-2 and have those runners be in motion. Look for him to be aggressive with what he thinks is his best pitch right now.
From the stretch, and that's taken high for a ball. It's full now, 3-2.
Wow, this is a pretty good at bat right here. From down in the count, 0-2, to work the count back to 3-2, and he's seen a lot of pitches too.
He's set, and the payoff pitch. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. The next 3-2, and he misses again. Ball four, and that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on balls.
What's the saying? When you find yourself in a hole, the first thing you should do is stop digging. Well, the guy on the bump obviously hasn't heard that one.
Coming to the plate now, Mike Tauchman. It was a three-hit effort from him last night, so he was a big part of that victory. No balls and a strike to count. Two out, bases loaded. Hit in the air out to center field. Buxton is there now as he makes the catch, and they're able to avoid the huge inning here as the side is retired. So they wind up with two in the inning, but it could have been a lot worse as they leave the bases loaded. On now to the bottom of inning number one. The Yankees lead it 2-0. Jordan Montgomery will be on the bump for game two of the series. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, one of the strengths of this guy is handling right-handed hitters. Right-handers coming into this game are hitting under 250 against this guy, so he's doing a lot of things right when the right-handers step into the batter's box.
Standing in, Luis Arraez. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
The second baseman, Luis Arraez.
The pitch. And as the Yankees get started here tonight, guys, they've got to be considered one of, if not the hottest team in baseball right now. Winners of 8 of their last 10 ball games.
Yeah, Matty, I can't tell you how important it is to throw that first run up on the board. And that's exactly what they did. Little crooked number, a two spot to give their pitcher a chance to relax and go out and pound the strike zone. This team has been playing red hot baseball recently.
The windup and the 0-2 pitch.
He didn't look overly fooled right there, because a lot of pitchers will go to the breaking stuff 0-2, but he certainly looked ready for a breaker on that pitch.
Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Here's a swing and a shot back up the middle. And that finds the outfield grass for a base hit. And he's going to get to second now with nobody out.
This is exactly what you want to do when you've gone down by two runs. Answer the bell. So he leads off the next inning and gets them going with a double. Now if they can scratch a run or two across this inning, they'll be right back in this one.
So that'll bring in Byron Buxton as the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball 1-0. He comes in with that average down in the 240s. 6 home runs and 33 driven in. And this winds up inside for a ball, 2-0 now.
He's going to have a talk with the umpire after this half inning. Because if he's not going to get those calls, he's got to come a little bit more over the heart of the plate. And that usually means damage done.
Too high. And it's 3-0. Following next is Nelson Cruz. He waits on deck. Here it is, the 3-0. It's laid off, but in there for strike one.
You maybe get two pitches a game where all the guesswork goes out the window. This is certainly that situation.
The 3-1 pitch.
Hey, I love that pitch right there. Better execution after just giving up an extra base hit.
The 3-2 pitch. Swing, high drive, left field and deep. Boom goes the dynamite. Two-run homer for Byron Buxton. 7 home runs for him on the year now as the Twins have rallied to tie it at 2.
Well, that lead didn't last very long. Great swing of the bat right there to get your team right back in it and tie this one up.
That'll bring up the big stick of Nelson Cruz. As he looks at a fastball that misses off the plate for ball one. Comes into his first at-bat at 283. 15 long balls and 51 runs batted in. Now the 1-0. Cruz stands 6'2", as you see him in the right-handed box. This is the final year of his current deal, so he'll be a free agent at season's end.
You know, Matty, I know he's in the final year of his contract, but he's playing to expectations, to be honest with you. I know he wants to turn it up a little bit, though, as he approaches the end of the season and make that salary push as he heads towards free agency again.
Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. The 1-2. Miguel Sano will be next. No outs, nobody on. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
Talk about blowing it by a guy. Jeez, I mean, that fastball was way behind him when the swing came through the zone. I have to think he was looking for something off speed, and he just couldn't pull the trigger on that fastball.
So the big bat of Miguel Sano digs in next as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. He'll check in here at 256, a dozen home runs, and he's driven in 45. Now the 1-0 is looked at for ball number two.
Looks like that bomb earlier in the inning kind of put this pitcher on the defensive. Not being very aggressive right now.
2-1 now.
Not the ideal location for a changeup up in the zone, but he got away with it.
Had a good cut there, but he can't time the breaking ball. That evens us at 2-2. Hit hard to the right side. Foul. Already 24 pitches to this point in the inning. Full count, 3 balls and 2 strikes to the Twins DH.
Looked like he tried to elevate a fastball on that 2-2 pitch there, but kind of overdid it. With a pitch that high, it's pretty easy to lay off if you're the hitter.
Now this is lined into left field for a base hit. And he's in there easily at second with a one out double.
You don't think being a starting pitcher in this league will test your resolve? He's already given up more runs in the first inning in this one than he did his entire last start. That's the kind of roller coaster ride that will make you a little crazy. But that's kind of how baseball works sometimes.
Now at the plate, Mitch Garver. He's currently ninth in the American League batting race entering play.
This season really shouldn't come as a surprise to many. We all know what kind of skill this guy produces when he has a bat in his hands.
He's set. Here it comes. Fastball swung on and missed.
Good job there to jump ahead with the fastball. If he's going to get back on track out there, the fastball is what he's going to start to need locating first and foremost. Then he can work his other pitches off of that.
Still only one out in the inning. That almost got him. It's a ball and a strike. One home. Count is 1-2 now.
Hey, last two pitches back to back off speed, then he's laid on the fastball. He could pretty much do anything he wants right here on the mound.
The 1-2 pitch. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2. Up to an even 30 pitches here in the first inning. And he gripped that one a bit too tightly as it broke down and just about got him.
Yeah, when you're almost hitting guys, that's a sign that you're a little bit too jumpy out there to start the game. So that's a good move by the guy behind the plate to just come out and talk to him and encourage him and settle him down a little bit.
And that misses ball four. So with one out, that'll at least set up the double play possibility here that could get them out of the inning.
Wow, he's looking awfully shaky to start this game, guys. That's 3 hits and a walk. And there's no doubt that he's fighting himself right now. See if he can get this train back on the rails here.
Max Kepler, the next to grab a bat. He brings a hit streak that currently sits at 6 games entering play. Offering on its way. Just able to get a piece of that for strike one. Off the plate and in. It's a ball and a strike. One and one, here it comes.
The count is 2-1.
Hey, lots of guys get too aggressive in a spot like this, but he's done a nice job of gaining some count leverage. Look for him to put the ball in play hard.
And the 2-1. started to go around, but he's able to check his swing for ball three. Pulled toward right center field. Judge is on his horse. He gets there, and that's the second out.
Batting seventh, the left fielder, Eddie Rosario.
Settling in now, Eddie Rosario. And now the Twins look to plate more in the opening frame. Hoping to limit the damage, here's the pitch. And he misses inside with that one, ball one. Two men are on with two men out. Who pulled the string and had him way out in front, a ball and a strike. Here's the 1-1.
That's a ball.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot he's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
Grounded to first. And this gets right through him, and that may be a run. And they'll put the brakes on that runner at third, and that means the bases are loaded now with two away.
Yeah, I'm not sure. This ball might have caught him in between hops. He looked unsure which way to turn his glove, and the next thing you know, it's by him.
Stepping in, Josh Donaldson, eighth batter of the inning now with the bases loaded and two away. Here's the first pitch to him.
So important getting ahead with the bases loaded. Already a difficult situation, so you don't want to make it any harder by falling behind in the count.
Ready with the 0-1. And he comes back with a pitch that misses here. 1-1 to the Minnesota third baseman. Ball and two strikes.
A strike away now from getting out of this mess. Sometimes pitching is all about minimizing, right? So keeping it to two runs across in the inning would be huge.
And it's fouled away. A 1-2 pitch. Got him. So the damage winds up not being as bad as it could have been, as they'll strand the bases loaded. The side is retired. But two-run score for the Twins, both coming on this two-run home run. Second inning coming up, and we're deadlocked now at two apiece. Stepping into the box, Luke Voit. And the home away splits tell us he's actually quite a bit better hitting on the road than he is at home. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. 92 splits the plate, and it's strike one.
Yeah, he made up his mind early to take the first pitch because that thing was right down the middle.
Now a changeup hit on the ground to shortstop. Gonzalez is there. And a bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out.
The center fielder, Brett Gardner.
Digging in to try it again, Brett Gardner. He scored after reaching on a walk in his first at-bat. Here's the pitch. Ball. look out, and that'll give him a close shave.
Well, that'll wake everyone up. Anytime you buzz the tower like that, there's reason for people to start getting a little bit edgy.
Hit down the line at first, but this will get foul, 2-1. He's fallen behind now, 3-1. Three and two to the Yankees center fielder.
I know to the fans that probably looked like something good to hit, but unless you're sitting breaking ball right there, I don't care if it's middle of the plate, that's a tough pitch to pull the trigger on.
And he fouls this one off. High chopper to third. Throw gets him, two down.
The batter, the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu.
So bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring in DJ LeMahieu. 50th pitch of the game on its way.
Two outs, nobody on, but a base runner here feels like it would really change the complexion of the inning.
Big spot right here. Middle of the order guy is coming up. Let's see if he can extend the inning.
Sent on the ground out to second, and that's through for a base hit. So they'll get a two-out base runner here as we check out the list of the best hitting teams roughly midway through the season. And you can see right there that these guys rank second in the AL in that category. Here's big Aaron Judge looking to follow up the RBI single from his first at bat. From the belt, kicks and deals.
Nope, ball one.
Hey, a two-out single isn't all that bad, but it can be when you've got this part of the lineup coming up.
Man at first with two out in a 2-2 ball game. Two balls and no strikes.
It's a lot easier to hit when you're putting yourself in good hitters' counts. This guy's done a great job not swinging at pitchers' pitches. And when he's getting the ball in the zone, he's getting the barrel to it. He's been hot lately.
And here's a fastball for a strike. 2-1 now.
Great job of doubling up with a fastball inside. A lot of times you'll see a pitcher go in there, but they won't go back in there a second time. This guy's not afraid to pitch inside.
Well behind that fastball, it's a swinging strike.
This pitcher's bringing it with some high velo. You better get that front foot down early and get ready, or he's going to throw it right by you.
Pitch in the dirt, and that gets away. And he'll make it into scoring position here with two away, as that'll be scored a wild pitch.
Well, this inning was looking routine, and then with one base hit and a wild pitch later, things are looking a lot different. Now a base hit scores a run, got to reset on the mound and make some good pitches here.
Two out here and a runner at second. Strike three called, and the inning is over. One left for the Yankees. Bottom of the second inning coming up, all square at two apiece. Here's Marwin Gonzalez now, and he comes in as a player to watch out for, hitting well over 300 on the season.
Marwin Gonzalez.
First delivery to him on the way. And that's inside for a ball, 1-0. And now a pitch on the way. Fastball well outside. Hit hard down the line, but a foul ball, and it's 2-1 now. Fouled off. Here now the 2-2. Is a swing and a miss. That's strike three.
Really good pitch right there. So you're moving the ball all around the strike zone. Now and then what do? You come in. That's a hard pitch for any hitter to do anything with. Yeah. Just really makes it difficult to get that bat head out.
Stepping in now, Luis Arraez. As he'll take a breaking ball in off the plate for ball one. Second shot now. He doubled to start out the home first. This is lined to left. And that's in for a base hit. His second in as many trips to the plate.
The center fielder, number 25, Byron Buxton.
So a runner at first with one out now, and that'll bring up the speedy outfielder, Byron Buxton.
And in that last at bat, it makes you think this guy might have went up there looking for the breaking ball, because he certainly got a breaking ball, and he didn't miss it. Hit it right on the screws.
Here comes the first pitch. Can't find the zone there as he lays off the breaking ball.
You know, I think he's having a hard time with that curveball right now, and that's part of the reason why he struggled early on in the start. It's so important to have command of those secondary pitches, or hitters just start sitting on the hard stuff.
The 1-0 delivery. Can't connect there on the breaking ball. 1-1. Buxton, or sometimes just Buck for short. This is his sixth season for him in the big leagues. Down low, two balls and a strike.
He might still be thrown off from that first inning, guys. He got knocked around pretty good, and that can be hard to recover from mentally sometimes.
Runner at first here with one away in a 2-2 ball game. Runner's on the move for second. Fouled away. Even at two balls and two strikes, here's the pitch. Grounder down the line at third. The 2-2 one more time. In the dirt here, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. The 3-2 pitch. Popped him up. Torres has a play, and he makes the catch for the second out.
Now batting, right fielder, Nelson Cruz.
Digging in for his second at bat, Nelson Cruz. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Ready with the nothing and one pitch.
No balls, two strikes.
Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning.
Some of our nation's young minds and future leaders here in attendance. Yikes. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on the show after this. Welcome back. Here's Heidi Watney with a report as we get set for the top of the third. Heidi.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with the Yankees manager Aaron Boone during the break about the team's offensive performance so far, and flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats.
They've already worked out three walks, so he feels as though that kind of willingness to let the opposition work themselves into trouble will continue to result in good things for them on the scoreboard.
All right, Heidi, thank you. And digging into the batter's box next will be Giancarlo Stanton, as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one.
Giancarlo.
First pitch coming. Here it is. Too low, 1-0. Now some action out in the Minnesota pen, as it looks like both a lefty and a right-hander are up to throw. Here comes the 1-0. And he couldn't pull that one back as he clearly broke the plane of the plate, and that'll be ruled a strike. On a line, that's a base hit into left field. So a leadoff single will be the start to their half of the third.
Well, last time this guy had some success, but he can't seem to get it going here.
Now
in fact, he's given him more hits in this one than he did his entire last outing. And we're only in the third inning.
And that'll bring up Gleyber Torres. He'll swing and lift the ball foul off to the left and out of play. On a rope to the second baseman. And it got there so quickly, the runner didn't get very far from the bag. They settle with
now
just the one out.
Catcher, Gary Sanchez.
One out here in the Yankees' third inning, and that'll bring up Gary Sanchez. First delivery to him on the way. He's set. Here's the 0-1.
I got one ball, one strike.
Turned on down the line, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. Working for the punch out and the offering. He takes strike three called on the fastball. Couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Runner on first in a double play situation, so you expect to see a lot of pitches down in the zone. So I think that pitch up right there was a good one. Obviously, the double play is more efficient, but you're always going to take a K when you're on the mound.
And that'll bring up Miguel Andujar, as the first pitch to him runs a bit inside for ball one. Popped him up. Garver shading to his right. And that ends the inning. The Yanks leave one. We'll go to the bottom of the third, all even at two apiece. Welcome back to Target Field as we send it to Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. In between innings, I was able to catch up with the manager of the Twins to discuss his thoughts on Minnesota's lineup so far. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. It's still pretty early in the game, but they've seen a lot of pitches already, and he thinks the two runs they've pushed across so far is just the beginning, given the quality of the at-bats they're putting together.
Thank you, Heidi. Now the number four Minnesota hitter, Miguel Sano. One for one as he reached base with a double his first time up.
And he's got to build off that last AB. He battled. Usually when you battle, you get in that swing mode. A lot of pitches, you'll swing at the rosin bag. I love the fact that he was able to work a double in last at bat. Let's see if we get more of the same right here.
0-1 the count. The pitch. And he gets him to swing through that one. He's in control, 0-2. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Swing and a miss as he starts the third the same way he ended the second, with a punch out, one away.
I think that curveball is a big reason why he's able to turn things around in this start after a rough beginning. It's got some good bite to it. So that tells me he's doing a nice job of snapping it off out front, really finishing that pitch like you're supposed to.
Into the box now, Mitch Garver. As he'll take a breaking ball too low, and it's 1-0. And it's fouled away. One out, nobody on. One and two to the Twins catcher.
One and two.
To two balls and two strikes now.
Not sure if that was a great take or if he got locked up on a two-seamer running away, but either way, it worked out well for him. That's a well-thrown pitch, though.
Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball.
To be honest with you, I'm a little bit more afraid of the guy on deck than the guy that's up right now. If I'm on the mound, I want this guy up right now. He's the guy that's got to beat me.
Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Hit softly down the line at first. But this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Bases are empty, one man out. And he fouls this one off.
Not surprised he's laid on a heater right there. Just saw an off-speed pitch, wanted to stay back a little bit too long.
Another full count pitch home. And this misses for ball four. The second walk he surrendered here in the first three innings.
Well, the reason power hitters generally draw more walks than other guys is exactly what we saw right there. Pitchers work around them and nibble the corners a lot more so they don't get burned. He made some good pitches, but he just couldn't get him to chase enough out of the zone.
Now at the plate, Max Kepler. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far. From the stretch.
Ball. Ball one, no strike.
Runner at first here, one man out. Now a swing and a ball chop foul right at home plate. A two ball, one strike count to the Twins' first baseman.
That hook stayed up in the zone. You can see he struggled with that curveball early. He's trying to find that release point with his off-speed pitches. Love to see if he can find the feel for that thing moving forward.
And it's two balls and two strikes now.
Might have been taking all the way right there. That pitch couldn't have split the strike zone any better. And you can bet he wants that one back at the plate.
A swing and a miss, and another punch out here. Six already, and that's out number two.
That swing tells me he was really trying to get a pitch out front and rip it down the line, but that wasn't a great pitch to do it on. It's really not the best two-strike approach either.
So now to the plate, Eddie Rosario. Fouled off. 0-for-1 here in the early going. set to deliver the 0-1. Pulls this one into the air out into right field. Judge is on the move. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. Twins wind up stranding one. We're through three, tied two apiece. Striding in, Mike Tauchman. He's 0-for-1 thus far.
Mike Tauchman.
First offering on its way. Swing and a miss, 0-1. Pitch on the way. Here's a fastball that crowds him a bit, and it's 1-1. Strike taken, good bender on the outside there.
Hey, I couldn't tell from up here if the hitter was taken all the way or sitting fastball and just got knee buckled. Either way, that was a really good curveball right there. Move on to the next pitch, but have that in the back of your mind.
Count even at 2-2. Pitch on the way. Slider, and that's hit on the ground towards second. Oh, and it eats him up a bit.
Infielders are taught from the time they hold a glove that you've got to play the ball and not let the ball play you. You can see here that this one just ate him up and he couldn't recover in time.
Runner at first following the error. And here comes the first baseman, Luke Voigt. From the stretch.
Hey!
Swing and a miss, and he's in control, 0-2. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first down.
Boy, there's nothing better from a pitcher standpoint than watching that high fastball, a high piece of cheese swung at and missed. That pitch looks so inviting to hit, but it's awfully tough to put in play.
So here's the veteran Brett Gardner as the first pitch to him is a changeup that can't find the zone. It's ball one. Comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game. Down the first baseline, but a foul ball, 1-1. Two balls and a strike now to the Yankees leadoff man.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
The 2-1.
Ball three.
No reason to sit on anything other than hard stuff in a location you like and drive it right now.
Hits are now even at 4 apiece. And the count will be full. Now the 3-2 pitch. Fouled away. Here's a little chopper up the middle. Scooped up. There's one, but wisely no thought of a return throw, and the inning will continue. So that one wasn't quite hit sharply enough to turn two.
Yeah, choppers like that make it really tough. You can't make the ball get to you much faster, so the key is making sure you field it cleanly and at least get one, which they did there.
Rich Hill takes over here with the runner at first and two gone in the inning.
Hill.
DJ LeMahieu will be the first to greet him here as he stands in with a runner at first and two away. From the belt. kicks and deals.
Ball one. Count 1-0.
Two runs, four hits, and one error on the Yankee line score so far. And he gets a piece of it here, but it's chopped foul. A 1-1. Ripped on the ground to first. Oh, a diving effort as it's off his glove. And they will still manage to get him at first. A spectacular all-around play, and the inning is over. One error in the inning, but it doesn't hurt him. On now to the bottom half of inning number four, and we are tied 2-2. Luis Sessa, a right-hander standing 6 foot even, will take over the pitching duties here. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And that'll give way to the third baseman, Josh Donaldson.
Third baseman, Josh.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Fastball just misses. That's ball one. That's wide, 2-0.
You can see this guy's more focused at the plate right now. In that first AB, he went down on strikes.
Here comes the 2-0 pitch. Swing, and there it goes. Deep to left. No chance at bringing this one back. Boom goes the dynamite. It's a solo shot off the bat of Josh Donaldson. Number 18 for him on the campaign. And the Twins have taken the lead. It's now 3-2.
Homer last night too, so it's obvious that he's in a groove right now. My advice to this staff, don't give him anything he can extend his arms on. You do, and he's going to make you pay for it, just like he did.
The batter number
now, Marwin Gonzalez.
Marwin.
And that misses for ball one. 0-1 for him here in this one. Now the 1-0. Three runs, five hits, and one error make up the totals for the Twins to this point. And this runs inside, and that looked like it got him pretty good.
These guys are pros, and they're tough, but I know that one hurt. He'll never show it, though. Too much pride at stake.
Ryan.
Back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Luis Arraez. Already 2-for-2, he'll look to add on right here. First delivery to him on the way.
Especially after drilling the last guy up at the plate, that's just a great job to get your mechanics back under you and establish yourself back in the strike zone.
Nobody out, runner on first. And that's in there as well, 0-2 now. Working for the punch out and the offering. And a check swing here, but the bat clearly breaks the plane as he's set down for the first out.
Byron.
So one gone in the inning here with a runner at first. And that'll bring up the speedy outfielder Byron Buxton. Has a look, now the pitch.
Inside, ball one.
Runners on first with one down. Sneaks a fastball by him at the letters. It's 1-1. And it's 1-2.
Two strikes.
from the belt, the pitch. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two.
Boy, that's really disappointing for a guy that has wheels, right? All he wants to do is get now on base and take right advantage fielder. Of the strength of Help his game, that. Which is his speed. But Rude. With a strikeout right there, you can't get on first base if you strike out.
Here's Nelson Cruz now, as he'll watch a slider that runs out of the strike zone away for ball one. No hits to this point. Now it's 2-0.
Couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat, trying to get ahead and put himself in a good hitter's count.
Here's the 2-0. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Judge is on the move. He can't get there, so the inning will continue.
Hey, after that hit right there, D-Roll, that extends his hitting streak to six games.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Six days in a row with knocks will help you sleep better at night, Dan.
Here's Miguel Sano. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. One for two in the ball game thus far. Called strike at the knees, 1-1.
1-1.
And he takes one off the inside corner for ball two.
His pitch count is getting up there in the inning now. He needs to get this frame over with sooner than later, so forcing contact and getting the defense involved is probably the best thing he can do.
2-1, here it is. Drives it the other way to deep right. Judge is going back, but he can't make the play as it finds the outfield grass. He pulls into second safely, as also on the play, a run comes across to score.
The catcher, number eight.
When this thing left his bat, I started thinking it might have enough to get out of here. Didn't quite carry enough, but it does one hop the wall off the track, and he cruises into second with an RBI two-bagger. You'll take that every day of the week.
Into the box, Mitch Garver, as he takes a fastball off the plate for a ball 1-0.
These guys hitting aren't in first place by accident. They excel at getting out the early lead, so this is a big moment in this game. If they're able to lengthen this lead any more in this inning, they're going to be in really good shape to come away with a win today.
That swung on and missed. We're even at 1-1. Runners at second and third with two gone. Just behind the fastball there, two strikes now. Ready with the 1-2.
You know he's probably cheating on that inside pitch after he got jammed earlier. If you're on the mound right now, you want to try to hit that outside corner, and there's a pretty good chance you'll get him to roll over something.
Turned on, but that's ripped foul down the third baseline. The 2-2. Popped him up. And he'll get under it to put it away in foul territory, and that ends the inning. So two runs on three hits, including the home run. No errors, and two left. We played four full. It's the Twins 4 and the Yankees 2. All ready to go in the top of the fifth, and that'll bring up the big bat of Aaron Judge.
Things not looking very good so far in this one, but we're still in the middle innings. They're down by a couple of runs, and this would be the right place and the right time to get something going. The last thing they want to do is to try to come from behind and win this one in the eighth or ninth inning.
Strike one to start the at-bat. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Tries to shave the corner with that pitch, but it's 1-1. And it's a ball and two strikes now to Aaron Judge. Lifted down the line in left. Long run for the left fielder. On the warning track, he makes the catch.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Giancarlo Stanton.
Giancarlo Stanton now, 1-for-2 on his line so far in the game. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. And he lays off there, 1-0. A ball and a strike.
One ball, one strike.
And here's a fastball, not close, as he runs it to 2-1 now. Takes that one a little bit low. Three balls and a strike now.
They know the threat this guy possesses at the plate. I know it's 3-1 in this situation right here, but I can't imagine anything comes over the heart of the plate.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. No offer from Stanton. It's ball four, so he'll head down to first.
Up next for the Yankees, the shortstop, Labor.
At the plate, Torres. 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes.
That's out.
He couldn't catch up with the gas that time. Into the corner and slicing foul. The 1-2. And this one's in the dirt, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. So a full count now.
We could see the runner in motion here on a 3-2 count with one out. There's a pretty good chance he's going to get a pitch to swing at, and if not, it's ball four anyways.
And it's fouled away. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side. Arias ranges back and he has it for out number two.
Now batting, catcher Gary Sanchez.
Stepping in, Gary Sanchez. He got called out on strikes his last time through.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system. Especially now, he's got to bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
Too high, 1-0. Fastball laid off well below the knees. 4-2 our score here as we play inning number 5. 2-1 after the foul ball there. As a look, now the pitch. 3-1 now as that misses down and in. Miguel Andujar would be next. And he fouls this one off.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Now the payoff pitch home. Freezes him. A strikeout looking. One left for the Yankees. They trail it here 4-2. Ready once again, Max Kepler. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
The first baseman, Max.
Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. And here's a fastball called for strike one. And he falls behind 0-2. Nothing in two count, and the pitch. Slow roller down the third baseline. This is on the ground over to first. Throws in time, and that's out number one.
The left fielder, number 20, Eddie Rosario.
Up next for Minnesota, Eddie Rosario. He's 0-2 in the ballgame so far. First offering on its way.
Ball. Ball one, no strike.
One ball, one strike, the count. Inside with the slider, and that'll back him up a bit.
Nope.
Slider misses, and he's in danger of losing him here, 3-1.
Back-to-back sliders in on the hands. He didn't handle it real well at all on the previous pitch, so why not come right back with it again? Better job of laying off that one, though.
Can't keep that one fair, and now the count's full.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
And that's outside. He lost him, ball four.
The third baseman, number 24, Josh.
So a runner at first with one man gone, and here's Donaldson.
The last at bat, Matty B, we heard this guy's a good fastball hitter. He got a fastball and didn't miss it. We'll see if they pitch him a little bit differently this time and mix in some off-speed pitches.
From the belt, kicks and deals. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. Runner at first here, one man out. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
Clearly working the bottom of the zone, trying to get a ground ball for a double play.
Now the 2-0 home. A swing and a miss. That's the first strike.
Two balls, one strike.
Fouled off. Got him on the good slider there. Swung on and missed as he's down on strikes for the second time tonight.
You know what was really impressive to me about that strikeout? He fell behind 2-0 to start the at bat. That's a pretty bad place to be, but then he kind of refocused himself and came right back with three quality pitches in a row to sit him down. That's not easy to do, but now his focus has to hone in on getting ahead on the next guy.
And a high strike to begin the at bat. It's 0-1. Two out with the man at first.
Nope.
Breaking ball below the zone. That's ball one. And he lays off for a ball. 2-1.
2-1.
Has a look. Now the pitch.
ball. That's
never tempted to swing at that ball down low. It's ball three.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
A runner on first with two away. To first. Oh, and he can't come up with it. A toss behind the back. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. So they pick up no runs, no hits, no errors, and a runner left on. Five innings complete. It's the Twins 4 and the Yankees 2. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and striding into the plate, it'll be Miguel Andujar. First pitch coming. Here it is. A ball and no strikes.
Hey, every ball club has that spark plug guy, and this is the guy right here. He usually ignites a lot of productive innings.
And wow, a very high strike, but a strike nonetheless, and it's 1-1. Fastball close, but he didn't get it. 2-1. Here's the pitch. In the air to center. Center fielder giving chase. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out.
Up next for the Yankees, the left fielder, Mike Tauchman.
At the plate, Mike Tauchman, 0-for-2 for him to this point. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-1. We're in the sixth inning now of a 4-2 ball game. And this is swung out and missed, so it's two up, two down to start the sixth inning.
The batter. The first
digging in now, Luke Voit. He's grounded out and struck out in his two trips to the plate. First delivery to him on the way.
1-0.
Hey, a two-out walk right here would be the tying run to the plate. Even though it's early on, you've got a guy on deck that has a lot of pop.
Here's a swing and a ground ball. And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit.
Now batting, the center fielder, Brett Gardner.
At the plate now, Brett Gardner, as he rips it on the ground to second. He's got it. Throw to second for the force out, and the side is retired. The Yanks leave one, still down by a count of 4-2. Ben Heller enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Number 61, Ben Heller.
Bottom of the sixth inning now, and that will bring in the second baseman, Luis Arraez.
Luis Arraez.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Heller, originally from the Badger state of Wisconsin. He was taken in the 22nd round back in the draft of 2013.
I know this guy wouldn't go into the category of superstar, but to grind out the career he has being drafted where he was, my hat's off to him.
Now a fastball off the plate away, a ball and a strike. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Tuchman is right there as he puts it away, no problem for the first out.
The center fielder, number 25, Byron Buxton.
Byron Buxton will stand in here, but before he does, let's take you back to the very first inning. This was a two-run home run right out of the gate that really got these guys off to a fast start. Now here's the pitch. Good fastball as he gets the swing and a miss. And it looks like the Yankees will have a left-hander up and throwing in the bullpen. The windup and the 0-1. Tried to get him to go after the slider, but it's 1-1. And he popped him up over toward the left side of the infield. And he'll put this away for the second out.
Now batting, the right fielder, Nelson Cruz.
Digging in and looking for more, Nelson Cruz. He steps in off a base hit in his last at-bat. First offering on its way. And he takes a cold strike, 0-1.
Hey, there aren't too many power hitters in the game that would let that pitch go by.
Well out in front of the breaking ball there for a strike.
Hey, this is an amazing inning right here. Attacking the zone, keeping his defense invested. Chance to get off the field super quick.
Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch.
The count is 1-2.
Not sure if that was a purpose pitch or not, but I liked it. As a pitcher, sometimes you've got to be willing to back the guy off the plate by running something hard inside. You can't just let guys be comfortable standing in the batter's box against you.
Two out, nobody on. And it's to 2-2 now with the bases empty and two gone here in the inning. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one. Down go the Twins in order, but they still lead this one 4-2. Seventh inning ready to roll, and that'll give way to the veteran second baseman, DJ LeMahieu.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast? They could certainly use that right now.
And he'll start the inning with a pitch that misses off the plate. It's ball one. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Racing back the center fielder. On the warning track, he makes the catch.
The right fielder, number 99, Aaron Judge.
One gone here in the Yankee seventh, and that'll bring up the former American League Rookie of the Year, Big Aaron Judge. First pitch on its way.
Count 1-0.
The 1-0 home.
Ball two.
Seventh inning here at the ballpark. 4-2 our score. Too tight with that one. 3-0.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters. So you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
And this misses here for ball four. Just the second walk he's issued here into his seventh inning of work.
And with the bases empty and three balls, I think they were probably just saying, hey, we're not going to compound our mistakes here. Better issue a free pass and give him something to drive.
Corey Guerin takes the mound now, and it appears he's being brought in to face the right-handed batter who waits next.
Yeah, you usually don't hear the term righty specialist very often, but that's kind of how they're using him here, Matt. Most hitters have a harder time against pitchers of the same handedness, so we'll see if this move pans out.
Giancarlo Stanton will be the first to greet him here as he'll stand in with a runner at first and one away. He's set and the pitch.
Ball.
The 1-0. Finds the zone, strike one. Guerin was known as a short relief specialist, a guy who came in, got one or two big outs, but with the new pace of play rules, they're forcing a change for this right-hander. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch, but if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
Looked like he got fooled on the speed there. 2-2.
That's three straight sliders in a row. I'd be shocked. I would be shocked if he went to that well a fourth time. I'd be looking heater.
Here now the 2-2. Freezes him on the inside, strike three.
Now batter.
So stepping in, Torres. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Almost, Maddie. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
Now the Twins are going to get a lefty up and throwing in the bullpen. One oh count, here it is. And he watches one miss outside. 2-0 now.
Hey, after those two breaking balls missed, you have to be sitting on a fastball right here.
Two out with the man at first. Takes this the other way to right, and that's in there. Base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Now batter.
Hey, guys, right there. You look for weaknesses. Can a guy come in? Can he command in? Obviously not the case in this situation. He went to the well outside half three times, and eventually the batter made a nice adjustment.
Into the box, Gary Sanchez. And, Dan, this could be a real make-or-break situation at this point in the game.
Yeah, Matt, at least scoring one run in this inning is so important to them to possibly get back into this thing. Baseball doesn't have a clock, but you only have 27 outs to work with. They're running out of those pretty quick.
Here comes the first pitch. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
Well, the Yankees have been searching for that big hit pretty much all game. It remains to see if they can get it, but now it sure would be a good time.
1-0 pitch is a slider, swung on and missed, 1-1.
I love the fact that this batter continues to be aggressive, but after striking out twice already, maybe he's got to take a step back, see the ball a little bit deeper, and be willing to work deep into the count.
There's ball two as the slider dips below the zone. Trying to hang a zero. Here's the pitch. Got him. And he goes down on strikes for the third time. Yanks strand a pair. They trail it here 4-2. Now is the designated hitter, Miguel Sano. So far, 2-for-3 in this one.
Miguel Sano.
First delivery to him on the way. off the plate and away there. One ball, no strikes. Well behind that fastball. It's a swinging strike. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. And he misses. 2-1. Fouled away. Here now the 2-2. He swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
The catcher, number
into
eight.
The box now, Mitch Garver. In his last at bat, he popped out in foul ground.
Yeah, we used to have a saying right here. You would stride to the plate for this AB trying to chop wood. Not in today's game. You just want to get your bat plane on the same path of the ball. Can't continue to swing under those elevated heaters.
That misses wide. One ball and one strike. One out, nobody on. 2-1. Now here's the pitch. Ripped down the line, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2.
He's going to be thinking about that pitch all night if he doesn't have a big game right here. Pulled his front shoulder and everything went with it.
And a swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there. Two away.
I'll tell you, it's hard to get more of a confidence boost than striking out the best hitters in the lineup. Back to back to back. He's looking really sharp right now.
Kepler.
At the plate, Max Kepler. And he takes ball one. He could really use a knock here. 0 for 3 in the game so far. The 1-0 delivery. Right side, defense aligned perfectly. Gloved by LeMahieu. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Twins are set down 1-2-3 as they can't add to their 4-2 lead. Trevor May has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 65, Trevor May.
Ready to begin the eighth, and striding into the plate, it'll be Miguel Andujar.
Miguel Andujar.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Fastball was too much for him there. Swung right through it.
Looked like he was going to wait him out, see if he was going to come over the heart of the plate. Well, newsflash, he is, and this hitter is going to adjust his batting gloves, and he better be ready in the box.
Comes set, and the 0-1. And it's fouled away. Tried to get him to go after the slider, but it's 1-2. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout there.
Yeah, Matt, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone of protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
Standing in now, Mike Tauchman. And he'll watch one miss up and away for a ball, 1-0. He's hitless in 3 at-bats to this point. The 1-0 is swung on and missed, and that's strike one. Getting late, 4-2 our score as we play the eighth inning. And a good eye as he lays off, and the count moves to 2-1 now on the Yankee left fielder. fouls this one off. Here now the 2-2. And another foul ball. Here's the pitch on 2-2. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
Into the box now, Luke Voigt. This will take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Right over the top with that curveball, and it's 0-2.
One pitch away from wrapping up a very good inning's work out of the bullpen here.
Looking to set down the side on strikes. Here it comes. The slider freezes him at the plate. A called third strike, and the inning comes to a close. Three up, three down, three strikeouts. Not too shabby. We're back to Friday Night Baseball on the show after this. Tommy Kingley is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 48, Tommy Kingley.
Bottom of the inning now, and digging in is the outfielder, Eddie Rosario.
The left fielder, Eddie Rosario.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Swing and a line drive, and that gets down and ought to be good for extra bases. He takes the turn and heads for second. The throw is wild, and it gets away.
The batter, the
cutting it close here, but he comes through in the eighth to extend his hitting streak.
Yeah, and he was staring at his last at bat right there, probably his last at bat. Would have been tough to get him another AB in this one, but he's able to get it done.
Hey, better late than never. And I'm sure when he walked into that batter's box right there, he's thinking, this very well could be my last AB of this game. So if I'm going to keep this streak alive, going to have to do it right now.
Here comes the first pitch. Think he held up in time, but that becomes moot as it's a called strike two.
This is going to be an interesting at bat. I think he has to be pitching for a strikeout here, so we'll see what kind of sequence he uses.
The 0-2 pitch. Swing and a miss at one in the dirt. And he makes the throw to first. Donaldson is retired, and there's one away.
The batter,
good pitch
number
there. That was a nice job by his battery mate to complete the plate first after the ball hit the dirt.
Runner at second, one away, and into bat next, the utility man extraordinaire Marwin Gonzalez. Here's the first pitch to him. Drops in a strike to start the at-bat, nothing and one.
It's pretty tough for a hitter to go up there looking for a first pitch changeup, and a good job of dropping it in for strike one.
Hard stuff on the corner, and he's got him 0-2 now.
Hey, with first base open, pitcher's definitely going to nibble and try and see if the hitter expands the zone.
Runner at second here with one man out. Pulled toward right center field. Gardner is there. And he makes the catch for the second out. And no tag at second. He'll head back there with two away now.
The batter, number two, second baseman, Louis Arias.
So digging in now, Luis Arias, runner in scoring position with two gone. Trying to keep the game close. Here's the pitch. One pitch on its way. Swung on and missed. That's strike two.
Hey, this guy's got an 89 mile an hour changeup. There was a time when 89 was a pretty good fastball.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Gardner is there, and the inning is over. One left for Minnesota, but they still lead this one 4-2. Taylor Rogers comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth.
Number 55, Taylor.
So back to the top of the Yankee order, digging in, Brett Gardner.
Looks like a tall order trying to tie or take the lead against this guy who leads the league in saves.
Brett Gardner.
Good swing there by Gardner as he hooks this one foul down into the seats in right. Taken off the outside as the breaking ball couldn't catch the corner. Rogers is exactly what you want out of a bullpen arm. It's a rare occasion that anyone squares him up. He doesn't give up a lot of hits, and when he does, they're almost always kept in the yard.
Matty V, there are two keys to being a good relief pitcher, and always remember these. One, limit the base on balls. Two, keep the ball in the ballpark. You can't defend a walk, and you can't defend a round tripper, and he does both.
And he'll hang in here as he reaches to foul this one away. The 1-2 is swung on and missed. He got him. So the leadoff man gone to start the top of the ninth as we take a look at league saves leaders entering play. And as you can see there, he currently leads the AL in that department. Now at the plate, DJ LeMahieu. He flew out in his last at bat. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. In there for strike one. Lays off the slider, and it's 1-1. Starts to go around, but the home plate umpire says he held up ball two. Yeah. Nipped the corner, 2-2. And now this ball's lifted in the air down the right field line, but this will get back into the seats, so the count holds at 2-2. Bases are empty, one man out. Down the third baseline, Donaldson's there. On to first in time, and the Yankees are down to their final out now.
The right fielder, number 99, Aaron Judge.
Stepping up now, Aaron Judge. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. Outfield in the no doubles defense. Now the first pitch.
Ball one.
You have to find a way in this situation to look in that on deck circle and find a way to get your best hitter to the plate with a chance to tie it.
A ball and a strike. Now a swing and a ground ball. This should do it. Throw on to first here is going to do it, and the Twins have come back to even up this series at a game apiece as this ball game is over.
And he puts a bow on this one to end it. How about his 25th save of the season? He's proven to be a solid tool at the back of the bullpen, and every team needs one of those.
4-2 the final score tonight. The Minnesota Twins took the lead in the fourth and held on until the end. Rich Hill earns the victory in relief in this one, his seventh of the year. Taylor Rogers wraps it up for the save, his league best 25th of the season. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter, @MLB The Show.